Well, welcome to our talk studio. Very happy, as always, to have with us David Makali and Kipchumba Murkomen. Gentlemen, how was your week?
Well, exciting politics is heating up, so...
It is getting hot in the sense that it's still simply too early, but it's happening. Mm. Let's talk about Martha Karua. Mm. We are calling her Kenya's political iron lady. A candidate, she's an aspirant in this race. She's serious. She says her name will be on the ballot. Let's start with a look at what her presidency would mean for Kenya before we come to the actual intricacies of the race itself. Let's start with you, David.
I think we must give Martha Karua credit for believing in the things she says. The only problem is that she has had three faces of Martha Karua. So a problem of consistency and track record, good track record to say, in pursuit of reform, good governance, and articulating those issues. And I think where she has performed, where she has served, where she was responsible, there is evidence she did something. But then there has been sort of a flip-flop in Martha Karua. One, when she was in the opposition under Moi, during Moi's time as president, Martha was this iron-fisted reformist who brooked no nonsense and was really what the country needed. When she got into government, I think power sort of mellowed her, and exercising that power had an effect on Martha Karua. Because a lot of things happened under in government, when she was in government, which, when you look at what she's saying now, you wonder why she didn't deal with those things with the same ferocious, you know, determination. People have, right now, there's a lot of stuff flying around. You know, for example, they said during the story of the Atul brothers and the thing they did in this government, anybody who had a conscience and was in government would not have let those things pass, especially in cabinet. And then the report, they say she didn't handle her part properly as Minister for Justice. So there are things which you listen to Martha saying and you wonder, but why didn't she say this thing that hard? So that is the second phase of Martha. When she was in the Kibaki administration before she fell out, there were a bit of gaps in that track record. But now when Martha speaks, and looking at the pool of candidates we have, you believe that she really probably has the solution to fix this country. And I think that if she's given a chance, I think her government will be pretty straight in terms of the two things that I would believe she would do. Rule of law, that equality she's speaking about and treating everybody mm-hmm. equally, and the crusade against corruption, I would, I think, vest that authority in her.
Okay, let's come to Kitchen.
I think, basically, I think Martha, if she was to be the president, the positive is that she there would be some discipline, both fiscal and on issues of order, leadership. You would actually understand that you would know that your president is in charge. Even if she's making the wrong decision, you will be sure that it is the decision of the president. I think it's one of those, she's among the candidates, among the presidential candidates, the kind of leader that you would actually say that will be authoritative and take charge in terms of the leadership itself. I also think that one side that may not have been understood well about Martha is that Martha is caring deep inside her. I think Martha has fought for a long time opposition politics to the extent that she has worn a face that looks a bit more abrasive. But I think beneath that toughness, there is a woman inside her who cares about kids, who cares about people who are suffering poverty, and so that. And in fact, being one of those candidates that you can be able to say that she lives within her own means. She's not, she's willing to accept to have a moderate campaign, not to receive money from, you know, other candidates or business people or dealers who are likely to compromise what she stands for. And I think that is what our candidate is all about. Even if she doesn't win the elections, she will be out there to have proved that you can be able to run a campaign on issues that you believe in yourself.
Okay, let's come to, and that's very interesting, let's come now to exactly that, which is the campaigns and this race that she's running with all these other people. And interestingly, her approach has been very different. So we have the usual rallies. What Martha is doing is much quieter. She's going door to door and she's doing county hall meetings with the communities. How do you think that will work for her in this race?
There is possibility that could work if she can fester into the populations and spread her message. And I think she's being listened to considerably on the ground by women groups and people with ideas who want new, you know, government based on integrity and action and you know, issues. She's being listened to. But I cannot, in my own belief, think that this is the successful method to win an election in this country yet, because elections are still about showbiz in this country, appearance, perception. So she's not carrying out rallies. She's doing the county meetings and so forth, and she's everywhere. But I don't think that will generate the effect, the momentum that can project her to be on top, because people are watching and people get influenced by what they see. They want to flock with the majority, to the appearance of winning, which she needs to cultivate into her campaign.
So it's all about a one-on-one connection. But what you're saying, David, is it's not enough to have that one-on-one connection. People want the show.
We're not yet that sophisticated in this country. People are still really perception.
I think one of the things that makes makes her campaign a bit more difficult is that there is a perception in this country that if you are a presidential candidate, we must be able to see who is our representative, whether it's a region or religion or ethnic community or whatever in your camp. And the fact that Mother wants to run a clean campaign and actually wants a clear departure from the past, especially those who served in the Kenyatta and Moi's regime, if she's looking for that, that makes her campaign difficult, because then building alliances.
And possibly some who served in the Kibaki.
Yeah, exactly. Because if you're sitting here and you tell Mother Karua you need to form an alliance with Gideon Moi, she'll tell you almost straightforward that I'm not going to do that. And that is not, you see, the same reforms that Mother is preaching is the same reforms that Raila is preaching. But for Raila, he's able to, you know, package everybody else and say, you know, it doesn't matter, we have to carry everyone else and be in this bus and all that. And I think if there's a place that Mother will need to improve, is basically the perception that she's not accommodative, the perception that she's a lone ranger, the perception that if she was in State House, she would be dictatorial. So she needs to work on that by trying to bring as many people.
And lobbying with other politicians, pulling support from different...
And giving people presumption of innocence. I mean, really, just believing that as long as the court has not proved that you stole, I will accommodate you here. You are a Kenyan, and we will walk together this journey. We will, if you are found guilty in future, the consequence will come out.
Okay, let's go now finally to her chances. I mean, gentlemen, from what you've said, there's a lot of confidence here about her presidency, if indeed she was elected. But what is the possibility of her translating this respect into actual votes, David, very briefly?
I am yet to get convinced that she can marshal the numbers. She's good for Kenya, perhaps, if you look at the array of candidates we have, but getting those numbers, I think she is quite some distance. As Murkomen has just said, she has to build this thing that her team, her candidature, is not exclusivist. It's also inclusive. Bring on some people. Maybe she's gathering those people on the ground. And the only chance I would give her is if she's dealing with people on the ground who reflect her ideals and who have support. If she has that link to the ground, to the grassroots, then she has a chance. But
which means
at this
mindset
point,
change
I'm still
everywhere.
Seeing her not among the top three.
Okay.
Maybe more months to come.
Okay.
I think I agree with Makali that for Mother, her chances as of now are really a bit low. And the main reason is because her inability to change position. So she's among the people that is rarely, even analyzing her is not very easy. You know, you can't be able to say today, Mother will drop a candidature and be a running mate of someone else, or she'll form a coalition, because she's already taken a stand that, you know, we're not going for coalitions, we're just going to run, we're not going to compromise. And you know, but there's something about her. If she continues to, I've been seeing how she picks candidates for senatorship, for member of parliament, for governorship, she may surprise people, both in central province and outside, that our party may give a considerable number of candidates to various positions.
Interesting. Thank you so much, gentlemen. Of course, so we are asking tonight, if elections were held today, would you vote for Martha Karua? And the results, I'm told, right now stand at, gentlemen, would you believe 80% yes, 20% no. I think I can say it is one of the highest votes we've had so far for any candidate. We come back with your thoughts on her, reading some of your SMSs. Stay with Sunday Live.